Hello everybody, and welcome back to another weekly recap. In the weekly recap, I like to go over any news related to the old school RuneScape community this week. Now today we did get a content update, just a few tweaks to the new Bounty Hunter update, but nothing major so far. Another really big piece of news we got this week is the Gielinor Gazette for May, where they go over a ton of different things. They talk extensively about the new league that will be coming out in the next couple of months, as well as an inside look on some pieces of content and the future of the game. I'm also going to be having a quick look at the poll results from poll number 71 and anything else that looks interesting. Anyway guys, thanks for watching, I hope you enjoy, and let's get started. Now to begin with here, we have some feedback changes for the new Bounty Hunter update. Most of these are minor changes, but they've had a pretty significant effect on a couple of items. Now first appear they've made a small change to the balancing of the new blighted items. The prices of those items have been reviewed and the following changes have been made. Blighted potions are now 4,100 points, which is a pretty significant increase from where they were before. Already the price of the blighted super restore has shot up almost double. The blighted crombons have also increased in price by a small margin up to 1,400 points, and they've reduced the amount of points for the blighted anglerfish to 1,200. However, from a quick check, it does seem like the blighted anglerfish is still more expensive than the regular anglerfish, so nobody is going to be buying this yet. Now, they've also made a few changes to the task list for Bounty Hunter. They've replaced some of the more undesirable tasks with a couple of new ones based on the Dragon Dagger. Now, the new task asks you to deal the final hit with a Dragon Scimitar or Granite Maul. You'll only be given these tasks if you have the requirements to wield the weapon, so for example, if you have access to Apatol for the Dragon Scimitar. Now they are aware that the game can be easily manipulated by cooperating for kills, including for emblem transfers where a player pays for a guaranteed emblem drop. While we don't expect to be able to prevent players from cooperating, we've added a measure to discourage large-scale farming. So now when an emblem is transferred via a PK drop, tiers 4 to 10 will always be downgraded. Tiers 1 to 3 will have a 50% chance of being downgraded, and if a tier 1 emblem downgrades, it becomes 20k. Now on top of the balance change, there's also a minor quality of life fix for Bounty Hunter. The standard Bounty Hunter shop now gives applicable items in banknotes if you're attempting to buy a lot at once. Okay, the Blighted Teleport Sack has now become the Blighted Teleport Spell Sack, which can now cast both Teleblock as well as the Teleport to Bounty Target spell. Okay, and finally here, now that Bounty Hunter is back, they've put some of the other rewards from Bounty Hunter back at Last Man Standing. So from LMS, you can now buy the Magic Shortbow Scroll for 5 points, the Ring of Wealth Scroll for 5 points, Ornate Maul Handles again for 15 points, and Clue Boxes for 5 points. So just from this update, the Ornate Maul Handle's gone from 1500 down to 500 immediately, just after I made that video yesterday. Now, to be fair, the Ornate Maul Handle only drops 350k when someone kills you. So it being 2 mil was probably a bit excessive, and that's something I didn't realize at first. But anyway, they have made it more readily available again. Okay, so that's done with Bounty Hunter. Next up here, we have a few changes to the new player experience. Okay, so this week we're introducing a new NPC who will explain anything about account security that Count Check doesn't. He'll also point new players in the direction of the Stronghold of Security. We've also taken the opportunity to make some small, unobtrusive changes to some of the free-to-play quests. To begin with here, all free-to-play quest journals now have been updated to be more informative, the Restless Ghost text is now less ambiguous about the next steps, and Farmer Fred and the Sheep Shearer quests will now provide you with some shears if you don't have any in your inventory, saving countless adventurers from a short but onerous walk to the general store. So on top of that, they have made a few other minor changes, like renaming the Iron Man Tutor from Adam to Iron Man Tutor, just to add to the legibility of it, which I can understand, but it does kind of suck for a Bodhi. Okay, and finally here we have the Twitch Prime membership again. So now if you have Amazon Prime and Twitch Prime, you get a 14-day free membership for Old School RuneScape and RuneScape, so you might as well go ahead and claim it if you haven't already done that. As always, there is loads of quality of life changes and minor bug fixes, but that is it for today's content update. Okay, next up here we have another Gielinor Gazette for May, and I really like these things because they keep us up to date on all of the various projects that are happening, because there's actually quite a lot on the go right now. And I think this helps answer a lot of very common mundane questions people have about their progress. So again, props to Jagex, hope you guys keep doing this. Now first up here we have a section for project updates, which is probably the more informational part of the Gazette. Okay, first up here we have Darkmire, which we all know is coming out on June 4th. That is locked down, content's coming out then, no questions asked. Next up here we have high scores, and now they are aware that there are more issues with the high scores, although they are substantially better. They're still looking into this, but they believe it has something to do with high player numbers. Okay, so now for leagues, they are not revealing what it is yet, but they do have an awesome section below here that goes through the thought process on picking one. They pitched some ideas that they ended up not going with as well. Now there's a new team that is going to begin development on the next league. There are initially some new engine systems to integrate and test, but it is started development. Okay, so next up here we have Soul Wars. Right now they're still investigating what changes should be made to the minigame, as well as considering the rewards. Okay, next up here we have early game improvements. They are now at a point that they can start feeding some of the tutorial changes into the game. However, they're going to keep a close eye on it. They're getting to work on the next phase of the adventure path system, alongside a few changes to the early game content, such as the bronze only anvil. Okay, so there's actually apparently been some exciting progress made for the clan update. Content development on clans have now started with our fourth development team, the Juggernauts, which hilariously enough, I think is just mod Ash, at least that's what they say down below. So for Group Ironman, right now they're working on the group high scores, which is going to be integral to the Group Ironman experience. However, once again, clans needs to be finished first because Group Ironman is going to be based on the clan system. Once again, we have the new Karen storyline quest, A Kingdom Divided, which will offer some new Arceus spells. However, it hasn't started development and won't until later into the year. All right, next up here, PVM achievements. This one is not receiving too much focus. Right now, it's just a high-level concept, but no development has begun on it. Okay, so account security and login issues. Late last year, we explained that we'd like to make some significant changes to the account security features that we offer. While these are a high priority, our tech teams are still focused on delivering long-term solutions to the effect of sustained malicious attacks. Nothing too new here. They talk a bit about PvP. They are still working on some more long-term solutions, but right now they've been busy with the return and ongoing monitoring of Bounty Hunter, the 1v1 tournament, and Deadman mode. However, one interesting thing here is we're busy with the design of a new wilderness hub, which would host Clan Wars, Last Man Standing, as well as a bank and new activity center. It's kind of interesting. Okay, finally, they talk about death. They're hoping to deliver the death update mid-June, so coming up very soon after Sins of the Father. And they're going to talk a bit more about that in the Gazette. But yeah, that's going to be coming really soon. Okay, so on top of doing a brief overview of all of the pieces of content coming out in 2020, they also go more in-depth on two topics. The first one is leagues, and just to cut to the chase, they don't tell you what the next one is. But they do an overview of six different options they thought about going with, and I'm just going to quickly mention them. Now, first up here was a Kingdoms and Factions League. Players could either pick or be assigned to a side at the start of the league, and at a specific time, a portal would open in the center of the world, allowing players to enter the other side. PvP would be enabled between the two regions. So this one would be a PvP-oriented league, which I'm not super hot on. I mean, we already have Deadman mode. I am terrible at PvP, so this would not be my favorite choice in league. Option number two is literally a PvP-oriented league. But again, like, we have Deadman mode, I think that kind of already fills that niche. Okay, next up here is a seasonal league, and not kind of the way you think it is. Literally the four different seasons of the year. A seasonal league would split Gielinor into four different weather seasons that would rotate over the course of one or a few days, meaning each area would have a different weather at different times of the day. These conditions could have various effects, such as making the player's run energy drain slower, or making crops grow faster in spring. This sounds like a fun cosmetic change for the main game, but doesn't seem like enough to base a league off of. Doesn't seem that interesting to me. Okay, next up here we have Scrambled League, which would essentially scramble the experience you gained in each skill. So for example, if you trained woodcutting, it might give you runecrafting experience instead, which would really switch up which skills were quickest, which ones were slower. Again, personally, this doesn't sound that interesting, not to the same level as Area Restricted Ironman. Okay, and finally here we have the Gridlocked League, which is one I would be most interested in. Pretty much emulates the Gridlocked YouTube series by Framed, Puka Bear, wherever he went, and a few other people, and I think this one would be the most interesting. Now the only reason they didn't go with this one is because they didn't quite have the tech available to make this work, but I think out of all of them, the Gridlocked is probably one they're looking at doing maybe for the third or fourth league. I'm not sure when they're going to reveal what the next league is, but I'm really excited for it. Okay, so next up here we have the death update, which is going to be coming out very soon. Okay, so first up here, when you die, most of your items will be moved to a gravestone, which appears roughly where you died. If you are in an instanced area, such as a private Kraken room, the gravestone will be placed outside of it, as well as for God Wars bosses, it will be placed outside of the room, so you won't have to go get the kill count to get your items back. There will be a small fee to reclaim your items for the first 15 minutes. After that, it'll be sent to the death's office. The Death's Office will have a much higher fee to reclaim your items, however you can pay for the fee with items, and they will give you 105% of their GE value, which effectively is going to be an item sync for some people. Now, the new death changes won't apply to Ultimate Ironman, the Theater of Blood, Vorkath, Volcanic Mine, and the new Agility Method. And finally here, there is a change to Zulra, which is going to add in a fee when you die, only when you have done at least 50 kill count, and it'll be a death interface similar to Vorkath. And that's it for all the content-related information on there, but that's pretty much it for game information. Okay, and finally here, I wanted to have a quick look at the results for poll number 71, and I think this is probably one of the highest rated polls in quite a while. Just a lot of good quality of life changes. Everything passed except for one thing, and that was question number 26 for if the Twisted Ornament Kit should be tradable, and it won't be. But it is going to come into the game. One question had 97% yes. That is extremely rare, so people were very positive about this poll, which I think having a strong poll showing like this is a good sign. It means Jagex knows what the community wants and is polling realistic and positive changes, which I think is quite good. Anyway, guys, that is going to be it for this week's episode. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, I always appreciate it if you leave the video a like, and I'll see you next time.